Today I'm going to show you how to do a complete backup of your computer system using a Thermaltake docking station and a separate hard drive. This is the same type of hard drive that you have inside your computer, a desktop computer. It's a 3.5 inch. So we just plug that into the docking station. The docking station has a USB port, but it also has an eSATA port, which is faster, but our computer today doesn't have an eSATA connection, so we're going to use USB, and then we got the power connection here. And wherever you can find a USB port is fine. Just for display purposes today, I'm just going to use this one on the front. Now I already have the Acronis recovery disk in the CD player, so we're going to start up the Thermaltake disk. This is what our computer is going to be backed up to. So everything on the inside of the computer, on the hard disk inside the computer, will be backed up onto this. This disk then we can take to a bank safety deposit box or in the closet or someplace where it's safe. Now we're going to boot up the computer to the Acronis recovery disk. So since we want to do a full backup, we're going to select the True Image Home item. So it's asking us what we would like to do, and in this case, we want to back up. And we want to back up disks, not files and folders. So we want to back up everything on what it's calling disk 2. So that's what we want to back up. Up here we see what to back up here on the upper left side. So we're selecting disk 2. See if I can move that in so you can see it better. So what to back up is what step we're on. So we want to do disk 2 and we want everything on it. So then we go down here and click next. And it asks, do we want to create a new backup archive? And we do. So then we have to tell it the backup location, so we go over here and click on Browse. And it comes up with every place that it will allow us to back up to. So we want to select, in this case, backup K, and we'll just type in a name. So we typed in full backup, and now we're going to click OK. So now we've chosen the target backup archive. We click Next. So here's a summary of what's going to happen. It's going to create a partition image on the disk. It's going to create two partitions, three partitions, and then it's going to actually save the images. Now we're going to select full. We don't want to exclude anything. The archive protection we'll leave alone. The compression level, we'll leave that at normal. Archive splitting, we'll leave that at automatic. And so we'll click on Proceed. And this will take a while, so we'll come back to you when it's done.